Hello, this is Uncle Patrick. In the last two episodes, I shared with you how I got into an accident when traveling in China and my experience having the surgery done in Shanghai. In this vlog, I will share with you how I arranged with my travel insurance company to repatriate myself back home to Singapore. I will be showing you the arrangement that needs to be made to fly an injured person from China to Singapore during this COVID pandemic. I hope you will learn something from this video. This is my hotel room in Shanghai. This is how I get myself on and off the bed. After this incident, I can really appreciate the importance of having good health. This is how I get on and off the wheelchair. I would never imagine that such simple daily tasks were so difficult for a handicapped person. After I settled down in the hotel, I started to contact my travel insurance company to discuss how best to bring me back to Singapore. Since I was still able to communicate, it is better for me to talk to the insurance company directly instead of asking my family members in Singapore to help to arrange. My wife called their emergency hotline in Singapore and gave them my mobile number in China. The insurance company called me back quite promptly, but I realized their hotline staff have no knowledge at all about the policy. The total medical expenses that I paid was over 100,000 RMB, which is about $18,000. I was anxious to know what items can be claimed and what are not claimable, but they couldn't tell me. They had to arrange the relevant departments to call me back or contact me via emails. While communicating with the insurance company, the other important task for me is to recover as quickly as possible so that I'm fit enough to get on the plane. My injured leg can hardly move at all the few days after the surgery. The physio doctor told me to lift up my legs as much as I can. So I spent a significant amount of time every day just to practice lifting my leg. Doing it sideways is a lot easier as it does not involve the muscles around the knee. I also had to train up various parts of my leg muscles. It was easy for me to get these exercise bands from Taobao. I got them within 2 days after my order. From starting with one band, I'm later strong enough to do two of them together. This was after 1 week. I was able to lift my leg higher and higher. The back of my thigh was severely bruised from internal bleeding after the surgery. The massage by my physiotherapy doctor and my helper was able to reduce the bruise gradually. This was the result after 2 weeks. Besides exercising in my room, I also went to the hotel gym for some workout. Haha, this is much better than lifting water bottles in my room. And this is how I get stress relief and vent my frustration over the whole incident. Meanwhile, the repatriation team of the insurance company contacted me. They wanted me to decide whether I really want them to bring me back to Singapore. Initially, I was hoping I could recover quickly and could continue with my business trips in China. However, it seems apparent that it will take me a few months to recover. And it is not a good idea for me to visit customers in this condition. So there is not much point for me to remain in China. Hence, I told them to go ahead to make the necessary arrangements to bring me home. Flying internationally during this COVID pandemic is already difficult enough. Flying with an injured leg was quite a completely different experience. Stay with me to see what happens. There is only one direct flight from Shanghai to Singapore now, with only one flight per week. The only airline operating this route is Junyao Air. As my injured leg cannot bend at all, the insurance company has to arrange for me to take business class back. The earliest seat they could secure for me was 3 weeks later. They told me to go to this Safe Travel ICA website to do the necessary online applications and read through all the instructions. There is a lot of reading to do to understand all the new rules for different situations. We need to go to this Safe Travel at Changi Airport site to sign up for an account. Next, we need to fill in the trip details and complete the checklist on this site. Part of the checklist is to book the arrival COVID-19 test. I already have the TraceTogether app, so this item is done. Within 3 days before the flight, we also need to submit a SG arrival card and a health declaration stating that you don't have any COVID symptoms, etc. After staying in the hotel for 3 weeks, it's finally the time to fly home. The driver arranged by the insurance company picked me up at the hotel lobby. He let me sit up on a special bed with wheels which can be raised and pushed directly into the ambulance. Yes, they arranged an ambulance to send me to the airport. After the driver double checks that all my belongings are in the vehicle, we are ready to go. The ambulance is very spacious and well equipped. My flight is at 9 a.m. In order to allow more time in case of delay due to COVID-19 or due to my handicap, we arranged the transport to pick me up at 5:30 in the morning. The insurance company did this part of the arrangement really well. They emailed me a few days in advance the contacts for both the drivers picking me up at the Shanghai hotel and the one picking me at the Singapore airport. The Shanghai driver called me the day before and added my WeChat, so the handover from my helper to the driver and the hotel checkout were done very smoothly. The airport is only about 40 minutes away, and the traffic is smooth at these hours. We arrived at around 6:15. I have to get my health code and travel code ready to get into the airport. There is no COVID test needed prior to boarding the flight to Singapore from China. The driver has to find a way to handle both my suitcases and my bed. Fortunately, he's a big guy and there is no problem for him to manage everything. After getting past the first security and health code check at the airport entrance, we are now heading towards the check-in counter. The airport is much more crowded compared to Singapore's Changi Airport when I flew out 3 months ago. Looking at the queue, looks like it's going to be a full flight to Singapore. I got a surprise at the check-in counter where the staff asked for a doctor's letter to certify that I'm fit to take the 4-hour flight. They refused to let me board the plane without this letter. The insurance company had asked me to get one before, but the Shanghai hospital's doctors were reluctant to write one for me, and the insurance company did not insist for me to get it, so I had to call them urgently to ask for help. After waiting anxiously for about 40 minutes, the insurance company managed to get their own doctor to write the letter and emailed to me. They have a medical team themselves, and their doctors have seen all my medical reports from the hospital. I showed the letter from my phone and let the airline staff take a picture. The driver was kind enough to stay with me throughout in case he needs to send me back to the hotel. Once I cleared the check-in counter, he handed me over to the airline staff. Once the airline staff took over me on a wheelchair, everything was smooth. I was pushed through priority lanes all the way through airport security and immigration as I was considered handicapped. I also got priority to board the plane. After passing through the boarding gate, they pushed me through a different passageway which can only be accessed by their staff. I was handed over to the flight crew when we reached the plane door. I boarded the plane by walking myself to the seat with the help of my crutches. I was the first passenger to board the plane and they put me at the first row. This leg space is essential for me. Junyao Air is a Shanghai-based airline. They are considered a budget airline. I took this airline once several years ago. When I checked on their website, the ticket price for business class from Shanghai to Singapore is now 35,000 RMB. It is not cheap at all, but since they are the only airline flying this route, there are no choice for passengers. I did some cleaning with the wet towel they provided. The flight takes off on time. If you find my video interesting, please take a moment to like this video and subscribe to my channel. It's okay to turn on the notification bell as I don't have that many videos like others to upload, so it won't be too annoying. I found from my previous videos that many people like to watch the flight takeoff scene. I suppose many audiences are now missing the flight experience due to travel restrictions in the past year and a half. So here you go, enjoy. This plane has dimmable windows, which is the first time I experience it. I find the dimming response too slow. After pressing the button, it takes a couple of minutes for it to slowly turn to the desirable dimming level. Aha, this is probably the most enjoyable part of my trip after my injury. I could finally sit down, relax, and watch a movie with some snacks next to me. The movie I picked was quite interesting. It's about three young men who transformed a very poor village in Yunnan, China, into a modern coffee bean production plantation. Each of the three of them has different skill set. One worked in a big city as a delivery man before, so he is familiar with delivery channels. One worked several years in online marketing, and the third one has spent many years researching how to grow good coffee beans. The three of them overcame many difficulties and successfully built a multi-billion RMB business, bringing common prosperity to the whole village. This movie is apparently part of the propaganda of the Common Prosperity campaign that China's Communist Party is rolling out. I'm a strong supporter of this campaign as I believe it is the most effective way to solve the income gap issue for the country. It is meal time now. The food is pretty good, but considering the huge ticket price, I would wish for something even better. Four hours flew past very quickly. Before I had enjoyed enough, it's already time to land. After 3 months, I'm finally coming back home. The weather looks reasonably good. The airline arranged for me to be the first one to get off when the plane door opened. My insurance company had engaged an airport assistance service company to take care of me. Their staff was already waiting for me with a wheelchair. They arranged a lady staff with quite a small build to fetch me. It was quite a challenge for her to handle my wheelchair. She has to push me to collect my luggage first. This is the area where arriving travelers can queue to buy their Singapore SIM cards. This is the luggage belt area, and our suitcases are already sitting there waiting for us. At this point, another lady staff joined to help to handle my luggage. No camera was allowed at the PCR test stations. I have to book and pay for this PCR test online prior to the flight. After the test, they pushed me out to the arrival pickup area. During this time, I called the driver arranged by the insurance company to come to pick me. After a short wait, this van arrived. They got all my belongings onto the van. I transferred myself to the wheelchair provided by the transport company, and they have this mechanical device to lift up my wheelchair and got me into the van. The whole arrival process was quite smooth. About 1 hour after landing, I'm on my way home. The PCR test result will be out in a few hours. Before that, I need to be on stay home notice, also known as SHN. Looks like this new arrival procedure will remain this way for a long time. Okay, I'm finally home after 3 months. Here's how I'm being unloaded from the van. This marks the end of the most extraordinary trip that I ever had in my life. Now that I'm back in Singapore, I will need to arrange to visit the orthopedic and physiotherapy doctors here for follow-up treatments. The travel insurance will cover only 1 month of medical expenses after my return to Singapore. Hence, from the cost point of view, it is better for me to have the surgery done in China, as almost the full expenses there were covered by the travel insurance. Only the hotel and the cost of the helpers were not covered, as they don't recognize these expenses as medical related. Hospitals in Singapore have better facilities. Look at this sheltered drop-off and pick-up point. The hospital in Shanghai doesn't have this. And note that the wheelchairs at Singapore's hospitals have this leg support with adjustable settings, and I don't have to use my crutch for supporting my legs. That's me having my physiotherapy session in a polyclinic not far from my home. One month after my surgery, I can now lift my leg much higher. At 6 weeks, I don't need the crutches anymore, but the recovery journey is long. I will need to work out very hard in order to fully recover. Thank you for staying till the end. This is the last episode of this series of my vlog. I hope you've learned something from my experience. I will be sharing more interesting content with you in future. See you in my previous episodes if you have not seen them, or in my future series. Goodbye.